Very excited to have this guy on Ike Live tonight. The one and only Vance Sahorski from Line Cutters. Vance! Woo! How you doing tonight? Enjoying a beer with us? I like that. We're stoked to have you on the show tonight. We're stoked to have you supporting this program. We've run into each other a lot over the years. You've been hustling hard for a long time. I want to start right with that. Man, I see a lot of guys in this sport that have a product, they have a vision, they have something, and then they just kind of, they don't have the energy to push it forward. Dude, you hustle harder than anybody I've ever seen. Where does that come from? Where do you get the energy?
Man, you know, it's just a passion for fishing. You know, it drives me, and like you always say, never give up. You know, I love fishing. I've been fishing since 4 years old, and to be in the fishing industry, I just have this endless energy because it's fishing. If it was any other subject or anything else out there, there's no way I could hit it and grind as hard as I do, but it's a blast. I love it, and it's endless energy. Mike, what's up with the pink line cutters ring getting thrown in the basket?
I thought the winner of the contest for Eric's name tonight would love the pink ring. I just thought they'd appreciate it.
All right, so here's what I did. On my Instagram, my Twitter, and my Facebook, I posted a picture of a pink line cutters ring. So the first 10 people that say Mike Iaconelli wears pink underwear, I'm sending out 10 free pink line cutters rings. So go now. I'm giving 10 away. Mike Iaconelli wears pink underwear, and it's free.
I love it.
I love it, too.
Becky's entering the contest right now.
She's entering right now. She's on her phone. Look at this.
Becky, Breast Cancer Awareness Month, baby.
That's awesome. Speaking of that, I want to jump real quick and change subjects. And there was a challenge that I saw last week in the office, and I was purposely waiting till tonight to do this live, and I accept your challenge. God damn it!
We gotta get Damon John.
We gotta.
I will take you, and I will take Damon John down with my grandpa's 1940s Herd pistol grip supercaster rod and reel. We gotta do it. Me, you, and the Shark Tank legend Damon John, 3-guy tournament. Let's do this.
I'm in. Count me in 100%. I'm into. I love a challenge. I love a really hard challenge. I think it's going to be hard because you've got luck behind you with that rod. Anytime you're using grandpa's equipment, you've got luck behind you. I'm telling you.
Yes.
I accept.
All right.
Okay.
Cool.
Yes, I accept. Pete, would you accept?
That sounds like a cool challenge. Do you have to use an old rod too?
I could use an old rod.
Is that how it's got to go?
Maybe I should.
I
actually have a rod there. Yeah, bring me that rod out, Pete. Let me see.
You have to wear FUBU.
I have to wear FUBU. I have to wear Z Cavaricci's.
And you have to use this lure.
Oh my God! Oh, you're really putting me at a Brian Carpenter. Give me a little close up of that. I'm gonna go ahead. This rod's actually bamboo. I'm gonna put it early 1900s, maybe 1920s.
Yeah, how thick's that line, dude?
This is super thick line. Look at this.
It's probably 100-pound braid.
I don't even know if it's braid back then. Braid. This is more like rope. Look at it, Stefan. We've got
the line cutter braid.
Yeah, let's just see what happens right here. Oh my God! Look at that. Like butter, baby. Like butter.
There's already 10 winners of pink.
There is. Yeah. That was quick. Yeah. Pete, I don't know if I want to be restricted to that rod. I use an old rod, but that's ridiculous.
Well, you should be handicapped to a certain extent. Because there's nobody, as you've just demonstrated by what happened with James, nobody has more luck than you.
I agree.
Yeah. True.
You need a handicap.
Well, let's do this. Let me go ahead and throw this into it. I'm looking at right now, and Pete, if you want to grab it or if Becky wants to grab it, I have my grandfather's tackle box right here in the studio. This is a prized possession for me. This is an old green hip roof tackle box, 3-tier. I've got it right here. I'm going to open this thing up. It's got the old brass latch on it. This was my pop's tackle box.
Wow.
And I'll go ahead and accept the challenge and say I'll use this tackle box, and then I'm restricted
to
the baits that are in this box. It won't add anything.
What?
It's pretty slim pickings. There is actually a bottle of pork rind in here.
Ooh.
I think they stopped making that.
Oh.
Wow.
It was cloudy. That was gross.
There's a lot of creek chubs.
I look like a donation.
Look at that.
Creek chub with the glass eyes. There's a lot of jitterbugs in here.
Dude, you guys ain't gonna catch anything.
No, we'll catch them with this. I'm telling you. Yeah, we will.
Damon's gonna call up Ken Van Dam.
Yeah, Damon's gonna have Kevin. Damon's not even gonna fish himself.
Damon's gonna come in.
Yeah, he probably has people do it for him.
Damon's gonna come in riding Kevin Van Dam's back, cracking him with like a whip.
KBD, cast on that lily pad. Great segue right now, talking about Damon on Kevin Van Dam's back. jump into it because. Before this show started, we were all sitting out here at the bar talking a little bit, and we were all like, dude, how did Vance do that? Because we're all very outgoing, and we're all okay with speaking in front of people, but to be in front of the Sharks like that, I couldn't, dude, I'm telling you right now, I could not freaking do it. I get embarrassed and intimidated watching the show. Like, Becky will have it on, and I'm in bed, and I'm watching it, and I'm like cringing. I'm like hiding under the covers because I'm intimidated just watching. Talk a little bit about that experience and how you prepared for that.
Well, I tell you, it was recorded at Sony Studios where they film Batman and Bachelor and Bachelorette. So already, just going onto that lot, your adrenaline is just slamming. And then, you know, you set up your deal, and when you set up what you're going to pitch, the Sharks are sitting there and they're just kind of not looking at you. You know, you go up and set up your thing. And when I went out there and saw like Mark Cuban and Mr. Wonderful, and by the way, you make an amazing Mr. Wonderful. And you know, you set up your thing, you see them, like my heart literally, like my neck started swelling up and I could barely swallow. And I thought, I got to walk back out. And that's without the cameras rolling, then come in and do it. And what's crazy is I thought if you mess up, they just start over. Like, this is TV, right?
Yeah.
You got one shot. That's it. So they tell you that. They say, we're not restarting. Like, if you mess up, just try and push through it because you have $5 million of advertising on the line.
Wow. They have
10 to 12 minutes on ABC Network, primetime TV. They said if Coca-Cola wrote a check for 10 to 12 minutes on Coast to Coast primetime TV, that's $5 million. So don't mess it up.
Wow.
So
wow.
That's how much pressure you have. And then you go in there, and I was in there for 45 minutes.
Right?
Yeah. It was intense, and my leg was shaking. I got cottonmouth towards the end, and, you know, I'd practiced my pitch so much and, you know, just practiced and you know, ran through scenarios. And I got lucky and got the Shark I wanted because – Damon John fishes and the rest is history.
Yeah.
You know what I thought was so interesting though, watching, like, they, even though like a lot, you know, you only had Damon who gave you the offer, you could tell they all liked you, and that never happens. Like, I watched the show,
that hardly ever happens.
And they usually are like, like instantly nix, like they actually all liked you, even if they didn't want to, you know, go into business with you. You could tell they all genuinely, you know, wanted it to work for you.
Yeah,
it was pretty cool.
Except for the Croatian.
Yeah.
Yeah.
At the end,
I
was like telling him what to do.
Yeah, hey,
Ben. Wait a second. It's Polish immigrants. So, you know, I just said like Polish background. I didn't, you know? I mean, come on.
Yeah, but hey, Vance, Pete and I are both Polish. When does a Croatian get to talk about us like we're dirt?
Exactly.
We got Ivan Putski, we got Mike Ditka, Lenny Dykstra. All right. Who the Croatians got? They got nobody.
They have nothing. They do. They have Tom Hernishan. Pepion.
Yeah, whatever.
I have to imagine that to even get on Shark Tank is like one in a million. Like, how do you even get to be one of those people who goes on the show?
Well, 4% on average of every business that applies, it's about a 4% of the people get on there, and that doesn't even mean you're going to air. And it's not luck. I'm telling you, I originally dressed up as each shark. It's on YouTube. I even wore a dress and dressed up as Barbara. and had my Kickstarter video editor make a me pitching to five of myself dressed up as each shark, put a bunch of 100 grand candy bars in a box with a bunch of fake money, sent it in. They called me like 3 weeks later, did a 30-minute phone interview. I was so excited, like, honey, it worked. We got it. And I didn't hear anything for 7 months. Damn. Every time my phone rang, I thought it might have been like this could be it for 7 months. And finally, my buddy was going to do pitch his business in Dallas. I was at Houston at a fishing show. And I just said, man, I know I can be on Shark Tank. I need to be on there. So I said, do you mind if I go crash with you and go pitch live in front of him? And he said, yeah. So I packed up my trade show, drove 3 hours to Dallas, slept on the floor at some Airbnb single room deal, went in the next day, did my 2-minute pitch, and the rest is history.
Wow. Yeah, but did he get a deal?
No.
Wow.
Hey, Vance, what brought you to actually getting linked up with Ike Live?
You know, it's crazy because I've been a huge fan. I'm not just saying this. You know, Mike is one of those guys that just, you know, when I remember when I first saw Mike and he freaked out catching a fish. I'm like, who is this guy? You know? And later it just like, he is just pure raw emotion. And there's videos of me on YouTube. I jumped out of a boat and caught a permit. I was swimming while I was reeling and got out and I'm screaming. Like, just, I've idolized Mike for a long time. And later, fast forward now to Line Cutters evolution, and our fans are very similar to the Ike Live fans. So, yeah. You know, we're not always politically correct. We don't overly worry about stuff. We're just really raw and just have such a deep passion for fishing. No negativity, no drama, just celebrating fishing and just literally letting it all hang out there. So when I even heard Mike might even slightly be interested, I was like, it's like a dream come true. I mean, this whole thing has been like that. So Ike Live and his and your customers and Line Cutters and our customers are so similar and have so many parallels that it was a no-brainer. Slam dunk.
Vance, I got to say, it's awesome to be working with you. You know, this is, again, to me, I've been in this sport now for over 20 years. When these things come along and they're special like this, it's unique. It happens once every 10 or 15 years. You've got one of these products. It's so cool. And everybody here at Ike Live, I can tell I'm speaking for everybody. We're super stoked to be working with Line Cutters. Can't wait for the future. And I can't wait till our fishing competition. Me, you, and Damon.
Oh, yeah,
that's
baby.
What I'm looking forward to.
I'm bringing it.
It's going to be awesome. It's going to be awesome. We'll appreciate it, man. You have a good night. Thanks for coming on the show.
Love you guys. Thanks so much, man. So honored and excited. So have a good night. Line Cutters checking out.
Polish Power.
Polish Power. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Mike.
Appreciate it.
Yeah, I don't think we'll be working for Line Cutters once Damon sees this shit. We'll be the